way, this is your present. I'm going to give you at the end. So yeah, my new skill was American Sign Language. It was like ASL. Start. So ripping the band-aid off, at the beginning of the semester, I was in a really difficult situation. So this is one of the letters I wrote to one professor. It is really hard for me to say this, but I sent this mail to let you know that unfortunately I will not be able to attend your class anymore. I hope you'll not be upset, because it's not that I don't like this class, it's just that I've been going through anxiety and panic attack issues so far, and I'm facing the issues more seriously, actually. So blah blah blah. So this was how I started my semester, this semester. So yeah, actually I've gone through a panic disorder and anxiety disorder from last September. And on this March, as the new semester began, it got worse, the symptoms got worse. So I went to the mental hospital and the doctor said I have a major depressive issues. So at this difficult situation, as I'm a Christian, I thought to myself, okay, I'm not gonna drown myself into this fear. And as I believe in God, maybe God has some good purpose about this difficult situation, and I will not stop praising Him. So I decided to praise Him still, because just like a King David in the Bible, he was in a difficult situation, but he never stopped praising Him. So I decided to praise Him. Actually, I was in a Korean Sign Language Club, worship club. So this is me on a YouTube channel. So yeah, I already knew Korean Sign Language, but you know what? Korean Sign Language and American Sign Language is totally different. So for example, in Korean Sign Language, love is like this, and American Sign Language, love is like this. So it's totally different. So it's, for me, American Sign Language is like learning a whole new language. So I already know Korean Sign Language and I experienced the sign language, and I also like listening to English worship songs. So how about combining these two? So American Sign Language. So I decided to choose this American Sign Language. How to learn? I searched for a YouTube channel and I find this a perfect channel. She is Melly from Canada, and she's an instructor of my sign language worships. And at the first, I set a goal to upload 2 videos a week. I memorized all the lyrics and all the sign language of the worship, and I decided to upload 2 videos a week. But I had some difficulties, because in American Sign Language, I have to think and I have to sign in all English word order, I mean syntaxes, maybe. So it was hard for me to do it in all English, but actually, as I see now, it helped me with my English skills to improve more better and understand the English word order and English syntaxes more better by learning this new skill. And succeed or fail? I succeeded. I uploaded 19 videos so far, and I'm currently practicing 2 videos currently, and I'm going to upload it tomorrow. So how I succeed? I'll tell you the secret for of my success. Firstly, I practiced really hard. Whenever I was in a bed alone, or I practiced it, and with my family, I sing it out loud and sign it in front of my family. And whenever I was bored or studying in a library alone, I just practiced it. So I practiced it about 10 times a day. And 10 times a day, every day, is not a small number, but I did it with joy, because I was really happy just praising Him. And how I succeed, number 2, is image training. So whenever I was in a subway or a bus, I can't do it. So I just imagining as if I am doing it in my brain. And how I succeed, number 3, I uploaded videos on YouTube channel. So that made me so consistently and steadily do that. And to let people know about my YouTube channel to my friends, and letting my friends to know about my channel and give receive some feedbacks. It made me improve my constant. So this is number three. And number four, move on with your mistakes. This is the very first shot of March. And at first, I was very conscious of the camera. And also, frankly speaking, I was also obsessed with my appearance. Oh, maybe on my camera. Oh, I'm ugly in this thing, and I have complexes about this. But also I have a lot of concern about making hand posture mistakes. But as the time goes by, I just care more about the condition of my heart, not the position of my hand, because God is also caring more about my condition of heart, not my mistakes. So whenever I make mistakes, I just move on. So, yeah. And so as you can see, like in the before, I was like really stiff like this, but currently I'm more happy and more natural than before. And how I succeed, number five, I chose new songs every week, so I got never be bored. And actually it is actually 19 songs, so it actually reveals my whole emotion of this semester. For example, at first of March, I was in a very difficult situation, and I prayed to God, and, oh God, please, you are a way maker and a miracle worker, so please heal myself, heal my heart, and I am no longer slaves to fear or anxiety. You can make a way, because you are a king of kings, just like this. So it all showed the whole entire emotion of my semester. And I'll tell you about the good influences of this new skill. Number one is comfortable with me showing myself openly in public, because I have gone through the panic and social anxiety issues. I had a little concern about showing myself openly to others, but by showing myself open in YouTube, I got more comfortable with communicating with others. And number two is obsession with appearance gradually faded. As I tell you before, at first I was conscious of the complexes of my appearance, but as I record and documented my process and time goes by, my obsession and consciousness about my appearance gradually faded. And number three is I could control my depression anxiety because of the praising. I think, as you can see, joy is not the absence of darkness. I am now happy, very happy, because that is not because the depression has gone in my life, because I have a light that can defeat the darkness. Also, I have grown a lot from this experience. Non-Christians call them post-traumatic growth. So after these traumatic things, people get growth. But as a Christian, I personally think that I face the hardships with my faith and perseverance. And number five, good influence. Change the perspective of judging what's really important in life. So as I praise him in a difficult situation, my life has totally changed. So I want to ask you guys, what is your purpose of life? What is your goal of life? Many of you will say happiness, or comfort, or healthy, or traveling abroad. But you know what? I want you to set a higher and fundamental goals, because I was just like that. My goal for life was happiness and comfort, and I was broken just like that, as you can see. So I want you to set a higher and more fundamental goals. And personally, my higher and fundamental goal is to be loved by God, and that is never vulnerable, because it is in a script of Bible. It's written in the Bible. And this Bible, I personally believe this is the truth. So to be loved by God is written on the script, so it is never vulnerable. So I want to give you some sign language about the script. So John chapter 3 and verse 16. For God so loved the world, he gave his one and only Son, so whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life. So this is what I personally believe. So I thought about, I told you about the gift. So this is about the gospel. So some of you may think, oh, that is a religious crazy girl, but I'm so serious about this. I have experienced just like this. I have experienced so much difficultnesses, so, but because of Jesus, my life has changed. So I want to just give you this gift. And this is a small Bible pot card. So I want to give this to you, and whoa, I'm nervous. And I wrote everyone's name in here. Mm-hmm. Oh. So this is for Tanya. And also you can choose just one of them. Yes, bless you. And you can choose one of them. So you can grab it in the last time. And also, I brought these Chinese books for those of you who are Chinese and not comfortable with Korean. I brought this, so I'll give it to you. So yeah. So last good influence for me. I realized that I am weak, but God is strong. So I was so weak that I got depression and anxiety and all that difficult situation. But God was so strong that changed myself, just like here. So as a last step, I emailed Mandy, and the instructor. I emailed her, oh, hey, my name is Tammy. I'm a Christian girl from Seoul, and I really enjoyed yours, blah, blah, blah. And she responded, hello, Dami, I'm so glad to hear from you. It warms my heart to hear sign language worship tutorials have made all the way to South Korea. I'm looking forward to getting on your YouTube channel. Blessings, Mandy. So having gone through hard times this semester, what I want to tell you is that if some of you have gone through anxiety or depression issues or having some, not that serious, but having some kind of depressive emotions, I think that difficult and pain is worth it. So don't be so depressive. And I want to tell you more in my performance. This is a worship called Fear is a Liar. You know, we have an enemy. The enemy's name is fear. And sometimes fear tells us, oh, you're not beautiful, you will never find a home, you will forever be alone. But you know what? He is a liar. So I hope you enjoy this.
Rock your wrist. let you fight for your love's all I fear. Let you fight for, cast out all my fear. Let you fight.